It's taking too much time. Way too much. The other day, my wife suddenly tells me that she's bought a Tsumugi kimono. And she tells me this after she buys it. Her explanation is that I couldn't possibly recognize the allure of a Tsumugi. It was quite expensive, but it's really dark and dull. No, this is a fine kimono, she said. An argument naturally ensued. My wife tells me I'd have to wear it to truly appreciate its beauty. But is it that good?
Kusakari? Hmm? The dullness you mentioned is exactly what makes the Tsumugi special. The kimono can be divided into two major categories. Kimonos where colors are dyed onto white cloth. And kimonos where dyed yarns are woven to make patterns. The Tsumugi is a kimono woven with silk yarns. Its color and its design are plain and rough. However, it is highly valued as a quality kimono, requiring much time and effort to make. Even among the younger generations who have grown up without an everyday connection with kimonos, the Tsumugi is gaining in popularity.
I often used to wear dyed kimonos my mother had. The dyed kimono, you'd wear as formal attire. The Tsumugi, however, you can wear casually.
One can wear it like Western clothes.
That feels great.
Originally, the Tsumugi was woven with yarns taken from cocoons not fit for sale. Since olden times, the Tsumugi was the everyday wear of the common people. This Tsumugi was woven nearly a century ago. It was a piece loved and worn by a great Japanese writer. Rohan Koda is an author, well known for his novella, The Pagoda.
He only wore kimonos. He did not wear Western clothes.
Now Aoki, a great-granddaughter of the writer, had a mother and a grandmother who also had a deep attachment to kimonos. Aoki has published an essay about the family's deep ties with the kimono. It is said that Rohan used to wear the Tsumugi with style.
One cannot suddenly be able to look or feel good in a plain kimono. It's only after one goes through life, with all its memories and emotions, he can comfortably wear a Tsumugi to his liking. It would be ideal to have a Tsumugi come to fit him over time.
It is said that even after falling to illness, Rohan kept this Tsumugi on. The fabric grows softer as the wearer grows older, and as time passes, it takes on a unique luster. That's what captured Rohan's admiration.
Oh, Ms. Aoki, welcome.
Hello.
Please come in.
Thank you.
Because she's going out with you today, she's putting on her Tsumugi right now. Is that a tsumugi you have on now?
Yes.
Wow. That's really nice.
Let's first take a look at the tsumugi's pattern. Tsumugis were originally woven by the women of farming families for family members. The tsumugi started out as plain work clothes, but soon the women's sense of fashion gave it woven patterns. The first of such innovations was the stripe pattern. Roughly 200 to 300 years ago, when many laws banning luxuries were imposed, the subtle beauty of the striped tsumugi gained in popularity. After the stripes came the geometric patterns. This pattern was made possible by a weaving method called kasuri. A myriad of designs using this method sprung up across the country. So what exactly is the kasuri weaving method? Vertical yarns dyed in white and blue are placed on the loom. Then, blue horizontal yarns are woven through. Atop that, horizontal yarns dyed in white and blue are woven in. By skillfully weaving in the dyed yarns, a pattern begins to appear. This is the method kasuri. The people back then must have been fascinated to see, for the first time, tsumugis with stripes, grids, and geometric patterns on them. I think the sense of fascination is something we have inherited. It runs in our blood that we feel the subtle beauty and simplicity. It's part of our nature. The patterns on the tsumugi have been loved since olden times. The beauty lies in its subtlety. Today's first mark of beauty is the aesthetics of subtlety woven into patterns. A large design spreads across the entire tsumugi. A closer look reveals that it is actually a collage of countless minute designs. Each of the small designs is a mere 2 millimeters in size. The hexagonal shape derives from the pattern seen on a tortoise shell. As tortoises have long lifespans, the designs found on their shells have been used to represent good fortune. Before a tsumugi is woven, the yarns are dyed in a unique method. The yarns are partially wrapped with cotton strings. The wrapped sections stay white. Unless the cotton strings are wrapped with equal force, the resulting pattern will be uneven.
The most important thing is to have the colors even. You wouldn't make one wrap tight and the next one loose. You don't do that. You make them even.
For this tsumugi, roughly 80,000 wraps are made. The craftsman must make sure that the dye fully soaks into the unwrapped sections. For that purpose, the process of dyeing and then pounding the yarns against a stone slab is repeated many times.
The reason I pound the yarns on the stone slab is to soak the dye into every little spot. Like this little part here, that's only 1 millimeter in size. I dye it by smacking the yarns.
After meticulous dyeing, the yarns are set up on the loom. Every time a yarn is woven in, the craftsman checks to see that the pattern comes out just right. The tortoiseshell shapes, each 2 millimeters in size, begin to appear.
The very fact that such detailed, painstaking work is done on the tsumugi is what makes it so valuable. It is the intricate work that goes into the weaving that gives the one wearing it a sense of pride and makes him feel rich emotionally.
These minute patterns can only be seen up close. They're brought to life through extraordinary handcrafting skills. Hidden beneath the unpretentious design is absolute luxury. Herein lies the essence of the tsumugi.
I had thought that the tsumugi was really dull, but it turns out there are tiny patterns. I love the grid design on your tsumugi.
Well, you know, the grid design looks good on people of all ages. Both my grandmother and my mother wore this tsumugi.
No, I never would have guessed it was that old.
The more you wear it, the more it comes to suit you.
Time nurtures the tsumugi. Aoki treasures this kimono. It features brown and yellow grids on white, very classy indeed. Aoki's grandmother had it made 60 years ago. It was passed on to Aoki's mother before reaching Aoki's hands.
A tsumugi, right after it has been made, is quite hard and stiff, and often does not fit the wearer's body. But you take the time to wear it, and that is what it really means to own a kimono, to make it fit you. I think you need time to develop a close relationship with the tsumugi.
With time, the tsumugi grows more and more comfortable for the wearer. What makes it so? The secret lies in the yarns.